Today I fucked up, plugged up. Wrong lube. Today I fucked up, well, the other day. Still not quite right. So last weekend we were having a barbecue with friends over, the first since lockdown ended in our country. My husband really gets a good thrill out of me doing things sexually in public, so my kinky ass mind thought it would be a great idea to do something sexy for him. Mistake number one. So fast forward to the party, few drinks are flowing and we're all having fun. And I get a little provocative when I've had a drink. In my infinite wisdom, I slink off upstairs and go to grab a toy. My lush. I look at it and realize it's low on battery, disappointed face. I then think, oh well, I'll just put a plug in and take a pic for him. I decided to go for a big ass metal one, which requires a lot of lube. Mistake number two. Without looking at the bottle, I dump a load of lube on it and pop it in. No real complaints. Take a pic and leave it in. I then go back downstairs as if nothing is wrong. I walk over to the hubby. Ask him to look at my picture. He glances up at me with a puzzled look. I'm thinking, oh god, he doesn't like it. What have I done wrong? He pulls me in close and whispered in my ear, don't get me wrong, I find it very hot. But are you okay? I used the last of the normal lube this morning. It was at this exact moment my asshole set on fire. I ran with my cheeks clenched together back up to the bedroom and rebarked the drawer to find what I had used. Tingle lube. Fucking tingle. I felt like I had 600 fire ants gnawing their way out of my anus. Wipe after wipe and it just wouldn't cease. I spent the rest of the party in bed with an ice pack on my asshole playing the pain away. So yeah. Don't use tingle lube. Especially for anal play. TL/doctor, tried to be sexy by putting a plug in, used the wrong lube, burnt my anus for hours. Tingle lube was created by Satan. Such a specific amount of fire ants. This will be how I rate my pain from now on. Break a leg, 8 hurts, but not as bad as 600 fire ants in my anus. Till that tingle lube is a thing. Can't really think of an application where it would be more pleasurable than normal lube. I try to avoid tingling or fire/ice lube. Doesn't feel much better to me than just regular, and I've had women refuse to use it BC they don't enjoy the sensation. I couldn't imagine that in my asshole. I might as well go for the gold and shove icy/hot up there. Edit, in the over 10 years I've been on Reddit and across all the ics I've ever had, my most upvoted comment ever is about shoving icy/hot up my ass. Love this site. Could have been worst. An ex-GF of mine once sent me a video of her performing self-giving anal pleasure. Using a fully loaded Raid pesticide spray can, complete with hemispherical removable cover. The video wasn't complete. 30 minutes later I received it, she called me panicking. She uncorked the can by mistake while she was pulling it out after she finished, and she wasn't able to remove it. In the end she found a way to pull the cover out of her B-side. By pulling in her whole hand to the fist using a lot of olive oil as lube and grabbing it, and she chose to not go to the hospital. I wonder what could have happened if the can somehow was triggered by the action and sprayed some pesticide in her ass. Damn, couldn't she use a cucumber wrapped in a condom? Why are the absolute fuck would she put the end with something that would come off inside? Use the other end for Pete's sake. A plus for effort and anal. Today I fucked up by getting scammed for almost 2 years. In 2019 I've been in China for my studies, and with some friends we downloaded the app Tantan to date some girls. I talked with some, but one got my attention. With her, I talked about geopolitical and historical things, which was very interesting. But she quickly started talking about sex, and insisted to exchange some photos. That's not something I usually do. So I refused at first. She still sent me some, and even if she didn't show her face on those ones, and the background seemed to match with her Tantan profile. She wasn't talking much about herself though, which I found weird. After some weeks of talking, I decided to finally send her some nudes. Our conversations were very interesting, so I decided to trust her. I proposed multiple times to meet her, but because she couldn't speak English at all, she always refused. In February, I had to come back to my country because of the COVID-19. Despite the distance, We continued talking. Again, we exchanged some nudes. Just to protect myself, I never showed my face on the explicit ones, but she still has some photos with my face on them. We continued talking a lot, and the sex game between us vanished somehow. But 3 days ago, she came at it again, and sent me a GIF, saying that was her, and asking some photos. That's when I discovered everything. On that GIF, I found an inscription, which was the name of the Redditor. I looked at that Redditor's profile, and indeed found a video that represents the GIF. I began to investigate her WeChat profile, with some reverse photo search, and found out that everything was a lie, from the beginning. She, or he, I'm not even sure now, didn't threaten me with the photo I sent, and now knows that I discovered everything. I reported his/her profile on WeChat, but I fear that my photos may be used elsewhere. Too long didn't read. I chatted with a Chinese girl and exchanged nudes for almost 2 years, and I discovered she was a scam only 3 days ago. P.S. If you read everything, thanks to you. It may not be an uncommon story, but writing it here made me feel a bit better. And even if it seems obvious, be very careful with strangers online. I'm not especially young, and I've always been very careful about this, but I still got scammed, so it could happen to others. Man, I'm sorry, you must have felt like shit when you discovered it. Yes, I feel pretty dumb. Now I want to use this bad experience to warn people of that kind of things. Internet can be a dangerous place, all around the world. Maybe do another reverse image search on the nudes you sent to see if it's already being used in the internet. I thought about it, but I changed my phone recently and I lost all past conversation with this person. And that's not the kind of photos I keep myself on my phone. If I want to see me naked, I just look into a mirror, haha. That's a good advice for people in the same situation though. 2 years, WTF. The scammers on dating sites usually try to get money from you within weeks. What's up with this one? Been there, bro. You tried to blackmail me and ruin my life. My pics ended up on a porn site. Turns out said porn site was really nice and helpful when I explained the situation. They deleted the pics and blocked that person's profile. Although no doubt I have pics/vids floating around somewhere. It sucks but lesson learned, and at the end of the day yeah it's embarrassing but it's totally not your fault and you didn't do anything wrong. Definitely not Pornhub, that's for sure. Man, y'all really gotta stop with the sending of the nudes. It's a huge security risk. I prefer to have a painter illustrate my naked body, then I send the illustration via messenger bird to the recipient. Much more secure. Today I fucked up by breaking a $2,000 laptop on my first day of the job. I've been reading these for a while and let me tell you, I did not want to be writing one on the first day of my awesome new job that I have been looking forward to starting. This just happened 1 hour ago right before leaving the office. I'm a college student. I study computer science and was lucky enough to land an internship doing software development with a really good, unnamed, company near me. For the job, they provided me a brand new, out of the box $2,000 MacBook Pro to use for work. The whole day went great. I learned about the position and even got lunch with a few co-workers that just graduated from the same college I go to, and it was a great time. Up until 10 minutes before we left for the day, I had a minor software issue on my laptop, so my co-worker Bob and I started walking over to the IT department together to get it fixed. It was only about 20 feet away, so I just carried the laptop in one hand while it was still open so we could quickly show the IT guys the software issue. That was where I fucked up. Now, to get through the doors of this building, you have to scan a security badge for it to unlock. Before starting the job, I was told specifically by a higher up there, let's call him Charles, that I have to scan the badge when going through a door even if someone holds the door for you. Well, when Bob and I got to the door to the IT area, Charles just happened to be coming out. So after walking through the door he held it open for us. Bob walked through first, pausing to scan his badge. I go to do the same thing, pausing to scan my badge, and Charles, let's go of the door. And let me tell you, these are heavy ass doors that close automatically for security. Well, my laptop was in my left hand, and when that door closed itself, it used the screen of my Mac as a goddamned door jam. The base of the computer is intact and just fine, but the entire screen portion of the laptop is bent and broken. I feel like it's partially the other dude's fuck up for letting go of the door when I was standing there scanning my badge. But I also shouldn't have been holding my laptop open with one hand while walking, so I hope I have a job tomorrow morning though. Too long didn't read, held my brand new work laptop in one hand while scanning my security badge at an open door, the door closed, and my new Apple computer turned into Apple sauce. Update, I went to work this morning and all is good. Charles was nice about it and shared in the blame for it, and my boss's response was essentially the meme of oh no. Anyway, I was set up with a new laptop, but I'm sure they will never let me live it down here, haha. Also, this post got a lot more traction overnight, I wasn't expecting that, lol. Thanks for the support. Some of the comments made me feel less worried about it before I came today. IT might replace it the same day or give you a loaner. Your manager probably won't even know about it. Worked in IT for med large corporations, and if they're providing interns a brand new MacBook, this is a drop in the bucket. This will be IT's reaction. Grrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrr people, stop drinking coffee over top of your laptops. Don't be surprised if your replacement laptop gets crappier. Yeah, if my intern did this, we'd laugh and have a story to tell. No sweat, if happens. Dude, I did the same thing. 2K laptop, first day. At the end of the day, I carried some boxes out to my car, stacked on top of the laptop which was also in my hands. Set the laptop and boxes on my car hood. Somehow, transferred the boxes into my trunk and left the laptop on the hood. I had a steep hood, so I didn't see the laptop sitting there. I drive for 15 minutes. Get honked at like 3 times. Think everyone in my newfound town must be a complete jerk. Minute or two later, I'm going 50 down a fairly steep country road. Mac. Laptop hits my window, cracks it all the way across in 3 places. I still don't realize it was my laptop. Thought it was some road obstruction. 5 to 10 minutes later, I get pulled over by a sheriff. Ah, I really hate my new town. I roll down my window. Sheriff stares at me straight in the eyes, and says, "Is this yours?" Exclamation mark L. The man has my laptop in his hands. Looks like it went through a war zone. I plot how to break the news to my new boss. That's a cliffhanger. What happened? What did your boss say? How'd IT respond? You know you got that today, right? I wanted to dial a mile. If it makes you feel better, my sister was sent out on her first day and given the keys to the boss's Audi TT to do it. She reversed it into a pillar in the car park. She's been working there a long time,